talking to a young child about religion is like talking to a fish about water. If you're really paying attention, you figure out pretty quickly that they're way ahead of you. And when our son was about 5, he had a minor speech impediment. I don't remember exactly what it was. We worked with him on it, it resolved, but he was a strong-willed kid and smarter than was really comfortable for us as parents. He'd say a word not quite correctly, and we'd say, no, say it this way. He'd say it again, we'd say, no, this is how you say it. He'd say, but you know what I mean. We'd show him again. Finally, one time he just stopped and said, look, now remember this kid is 5 years old. What if I'm hanging by my fingers from the edge of a cliff and you're at the top of the cliff and I yell, throw me a rope. No, son, say rope. Throw me a rope. No, that's not right. Say rope. Throw me a, Well, he made his point. I believe God is like a loving parent. If we need God, if we open our hearts to God, does it really matter what we say, what name we use, or what image we hold? I don't think so. This song is called Angels. I wrote it for our 5-year-old daughter because she was afraid of the dark. Her grandmother had told her about angels, that angels would protect her even in the dark. After I wrote it, I sang it for her. And after I finished the song, she looked at me and said, Daddy, don't ever sing that song again. But she's 17 now. I got over that last year. But after thinking about it, I realized that to a 5-year-old, the idea that there is someone in the room with you, in the dark, that you can't see, isn't all that comforting. So I came to the conclusion, as I usually do, this song is actually about me. A song called Angels.